beautiful spring morning, and we've just come through the March for Our Lives weekend, which was so inspiring to see, and sure also to be a part of. And there were so many, of course, speeches to be inspired by. And yet what has caught so many people's attention was when Emma Gonzalez went silent. And it's such a powerful teaching and expression when we use the power of our voice to sometimes not speak. And what I mean by that is that a lot of us are not comfortable with silence. We fill up silence in every possible way that we can think to do that. We turn on the TV, we turn on the radio, we just jabber, you know. And we get uncomfortable when things are quiet. And when she spoke powerfully for about a minute or so, using some great magical tools of speaking, including repetition, she used the word never over and over and over again, right? And it really is powerful. But then she fell silent. And at first, there was like a rustle in the crowd, sort of, because she didn't say, okay, now I'm going to go silent, right? She just stopped. And the abruptness of her stopping being very symbolic of just the abruptness of things stopping. And people weren't necessarily comfortable. So at first there were the chants, go Emma, like, oh, maybe she got, like people thought, oh, maybe she got choked up or maybe she lost her place in her. And they were encouraging her, so sweet. But then that dropped away and they realized, oh, wait, she's doing this. Like, this is purposeful. And it was silent for a little bit of time. And then it was another sort of chant started coming out of the crowd. And again, very powerful when we use our voices in unison in that way. But it arose sort of out of this place of like, we don't know what to do with the silence. We don't know what to do with the quiet. And then they realized too, she's just still standing there. And that died away until finally they arrived at just, you know, these minutes of quiet. And we all have our own relationship with our voice and with our ability to speak in the world. Maybe we've not used our voice the way we've wanted to, or maybe we've been somehow held back from using our voice in our life, and when we finally find it, it's incredibly powerful. And then there's that power of having the power to speak. Sometimes your silence is what speaks the loudest, right? And to be able to punctuate with quietude in our own lives, even if we're not talking about speaking up for an issue or silencing on an issue, just in our own lives, it takes a lot of life force energy to express and talk as much as we do. We spend so much time and energy speaking, and if not speaking, typing and writing in some form, expressing ourselves through words in those ways. And so there's actually a practice that Some people in spiritual realms take the vows of silence for periods of time. Some people take them for the rest, for their whole lives, right? But some people say, wow, okay, I'm going to, I had a teacher once, and she just, on one day a week, she just didn't speak. She obviously didn't teach on that day, right? But she just needed a day to not spend her life force energy that way, to sort of almost like regather herself. And so it's a great contemplation to be in this place of like, how much am I always putting out and never going into quiet and stillness and listening and observing without having to keep filling up that space with something. So as we practice today, we'll do it, you know, in a way that, of course, you guys aren't usually talking that much anyway. We ask great questions and such, but I too will try to speak less just so that we have the space and the quiet around us to pay really deep attention and to cultivate that life force energy that stillness can, or excuse me, that silence can cultivate. So with that, let's go silent for a couple of minutes. Close your eyes.